In a previous video, I showed you how to connect up a ceiling rose and pendant or a batten lamp holder, and we discussed the layout of the conductors here and how to make them look neat in order to make the connections. But let's just summarize what that video was all about. We brought a cable in that had the neutral permanent line and a CPC. We brought a cable in that had the neutral permanent line and CPC going out to the next room. And then we had a cable with a permanent line and not a neutral. That brown sleeve in there indicates that that's a switching line conductor back from the switch. So you take the permanent line down to the switch and you come back to turn on the light. And we said that the flex would be connected here and here, whether it be for a batten lamp holder or a ceiling rose and pendant. And I took it out only to make the video obviously easier for people to see. I wouldn't normally recommend taking that out because it's two more connections to reconnect. So in this video, a question I get asked from my learners is, obviously, can I take another cable from here when it's already full, remembering the two outside terminations would be used for the flex? Can I take another cable out here, say, if I needed to wire a loft light, maybe an outside light, or take a cable into a new extension? And this was the nearest lighting point for all of those three scenarios. So I've brought another cable in here, which I need to bring the permanent line, the neutral and CPC into another location to continue on the lighting circuit. Yes, you can is the answer, but of course it means we're going to have to double up some connections. So I'm going to strip this back and just show you how to insert these and just the thinking behind it. Okay, so we've got our cable again. So in the first video, we looked at trying to make sure our conductors were in the right place. Well, I've got my neutral on this side here, and actually my neutral's here, so I need to turn that round. And we showed it in the previous video, because these cables come up into a ceiling, you just pull it a little bit longer, put a little bit of a twist on it, and then hopefully you can see my neutral now is on the correct side. And because it can move up and down, makes it a lot easier to strip it. I'm going to use my twin and earth strippers, or twin and CPC strippers, in order to move the outside PVC. We do love these. Just slide that off and then just confirm we've got our cable in the right place. So we're trying to take into the other room the neutral connection and the permanent line and a CPC through. So I've got those stripped back, push it back into the ceiling, and then I've got to work out whether it's long enough. Well, it isn't now, because we're obviously going to take a longer route round. So I'm going to need to strip some more back. So coming back out again, the beauty of these strippers are it's so simple. And then we can pull that off. So I've got them quite a little bit longer now to make sure I can dress them around nice and neatly. So neutral, CPC and line connection to take that feed into another room. Just push that down into position. I'm going to bring my neutral round like that in order to make my connection, and I'm going to join it into, there's a block of three here. Doesn't matter which one you go into. I'm not going to go on the outside ones because that's where the flex will go. I'm just joining the neutral in on here. So let's dress it so it looks neat still. Bring it round, cut it to the desired length, and we strip back. I'll use these again. Strip back, ready for my connection. It just means I've got to go in the same termination. Now, sometimes it's worth just checking to see how crushed the neutral was the first time round, that it hasn't overly fractured, okay, and looking weak. If that looked really weak there, I recommend you re-terminate, because you're going to screw down into it again. So pop that one back in. Put my neutral in with it and just push them into position and then tighten it up. So I've got two in the one hole there. But again, just be careful that the other person hasn't over tightened them and fractured the copper, because now all of a sudden you've screwed back into them. So let's pick my neutral up. Connection there. I'll do my CPC next. In the previous video, I only used one of the two holes I could use, so it makes it nice and simple for me now. I'm just going to bring my CPC round, put my green and yellow sleeving on. So let's put that on and make our connection for our CPC. Now, because there's only one going into the hole, I could double it over. Probably a little bit long, so just trim that back. So I've got the option, if I wanted to, of doubling over. Lighting points are probably the only place where I don't double my connections. Anyone who's been following me for a long time knows that I love a doubled over connection. The holes in ceiling roses and pendants, batten lamp holders, have been getting so much smaller over the time that actually it can be quite difficult to double our terminations in. I'm going to stay out of the way of the camera. So there we go. So our CPC is connected. Again, looking reasonably neat. We've got a line connection to make as well. Doesn't matter which one I go into. I could come in down this side here if I wanted to. Just trying to make them all look very similar. Strip that back. Strip it using a different tool again. I used all the different tools in there. That's got a slot for it. And just push it away and hopefully that will strip the end off. And make sure it's nice and straight, so we can dress it into position into the same termination here. Again, just want to check you haven't fractured the copper too much on the original termination. Looks okay. Pop in my next one and make my connection. So what we've done now is we've managed to pick up from a light fitting that looks as if it's fully populated, we've managed to pick up our connections for termination's nice and tight. There we go. So we can just dress it in now so we've got it neat. Just straighten that one up. And there we go. So we've got our connections now. So we've got three in our neutrals. Our outside neutral will be for our flex. So three neutrals, four in our loop, permanent line connection there, and our switching line. So this cable now that we've added to it goes off to another area, maybe an outside light, a loft light, or another room, and brings the supply, permanent line, neutral, and CPC into that location. You continue on the lighting circuit there. But as always, I hope this video has been some help.